So let AB be not equal to identity. A raised to 5 is identity. AB A inverse B equal to B square in group G. Then find order of B. Okay, so let us solve this problem now. Now we have A and B, which are elements which are not equal to identity. And the fifth power of A is coming to be what? The fifth power of A is identity. And we are also given that A into B into A inverse, that comes out to be how much? That comes out to be B square in a group G. And then we are supposed to find what? We are supposed to find the order of B. Means we are supposed to find what power of B should I take so that it will become identity, and that power should be the smallest power so that that power will become the order of the element B. So now let us try to see how to find that order. Okay, so we will start with the fact that A into B into A inverse is given to be how much? Is given to be B square. So when I multiply the same element by itself, so I will get A into B into A inverse multiplied by A into B into A inverse. So I'm multiplying the same element by itself. So here I will get B square multiplied by what? I will get a B square multiplied by B square. Remember, we want to struggle for the power of B. Okay, see right hand side, I'm slowly increasing the powers of B so that it will become what? Finally, it should become identity. Now, when I simplify this, I will get A into B into this A inverse into A. This A inverse into A will become identity, and this is B, and this is A inverse, and this will become how much? This will become B raised to 4. Now, what is the calculation on the left hand side? So I will get A into B into identity into B will become B square, and that is A inverse, and this is B raised to 4. But what do we know about B square? We can again substitute for B square. We know that A B A inverse is given to be B square. So A into B square is written as A into B into A inverse. I'm resubstituting B square into A inverse is equal to what? B raised to 4 is, as it is on the right hand side. And when I open up the brackets, use associativity, this will become A square into B into A inverse 2 times A inverse square is equal to how much? Is equal to B raised to 4. Now I will again multiply this equation to itself, right? Because I have B, I don't have a B square. So when I multiply the same equation to itself, what will happen? This multiplied by this will become B raised to 4 multiplied by B raised to 4. What should I write in the brackets? I will write A square into B into A inverse square into A square into B into A inverse the square. Again, when I use associativity, A inverse square and A square will cancel each other. Why? Because A inverse square multiplied by A square will be nothing but A inverse into A inverse into A into A. And when I multiply them, this will become identity, and this also will finally become identity. So the middle part will again turn up to be identity. And what will I get? I will get A square into B into identity. This is identity into B into A inverse square is equal to B raised to how much? B raised to 8. And therefore, what will I get? This B into identity into B will become B square. So I will get A square into B square into A inverse square is equal to how much? B raised to 8. Now I know what is B square. Now I can substitute the value of B square. What is the value of B square? It is A square into into b into a inverse square is equal to b raised to 8, and this will give me what? A cube into b into a inverse cube is equal to b raised to 8. I cannot do anything here because I have only what? I have only b, and I can substitute instead of what? I can only substitute instead of b square. So I don't have a b square. So what will I do? I will again multiply this equation to itself. So I will get what? A cube into b into a inverse cube multiplied by a cube into b into a inverse cube is equal to b raised to 8 multiplied by b raised to 8. So this will become, right hand side will now become b raised to 16, and this a inverse cube and a cube will become identity, and remaining everything will be as it is. A cube into b into identity into b into a inverse cube, and again now you have, when you collect this b into b into e, this will become b square. So this will become a cube into b square into a inverse cube is b raised to 16. What is the value of b square? The value of b square, I am again resubstituting. Till what step we are going to do this? We are repeating the same procedure again and again. Okay, if you observe now, remember you have something in your hands, the information that you have something in your hands is about a raised to 5. And what is a raised to 5 given to be? A raised to 5 is given to be identity. So I will continue this process till I reach what? A raised to 5. So still we are at a raised to 3. Two more steps to go. So this will be b square can be replaced by what? A into b into a inverse, and this is a inverse cube is equal to b raised to 16. This is nothing but a raised to 4 into b into a inverse 4 times is equal to b raised to 16. We are very near to a raised to 5 now. We will multiply the same equation to itself because I have a b and I need a b square. So I will write a raised to 4 into b into a inverse fourth power multiplied by itself, means a raised to 4 into b into a inverse raised to 4 is equal to b raised to 16 multiplied by b raised to 16. The right hand side will now become b raised to 32. And this will, this a raised to 4 inverse and a inverse raised to 4, and this will become what? That will become identity. And the left hand side you have a b, and the right hand side you also have a b. Here you will have a raised to 4, and on the right hand side you will have a inverse raised to 4. And now we have got this b into e into b is b square, and this is a raised to 4, and this is a inverse raised to 4, and that is equal to how much? B raised to 32. But what is b square? This is the last time we are going to substitute the value of b square. B square is how much? A into b into a inverse, and this is a raised to 4 as it is, this is a inverse raised to 4 as it is, and this is b raised to 32. This is b raised to 32, and therefore what will I get here is now this a into a raised to 4 will become a raised to 5 into b into, this is a inverse raised to the fifth power, and this is equal to how much? B raised to 32. Okay. So we will get a raised to 5 into b into a inverse raised to 5 is equal to how much? B raised to 32. Now what is given to us? We know that something is given to us. What is given to us? That a is not identity. It is also given to us that a raised to 5 is equal to how much? Identity. So this means that order of a must be how much? Order of a must be equal to 5. Why? Because 5 is a prime number, correct? So if you have any a raised to p is equal to identity, and if that a is not identity, that order of that element must be that prime number. We also know one very important result with us, that if you have any element a and if you have any elements inverse, both the orders are also what? Both the orders are same. Order of A is always equal to order of A inverse. But how much is order of A? Order of A is 5. Therefore, we can now say that order of A inverse is also equal to how much? Order of A inverse is also equal to 5. Since order of A inverse is equal to 5, I can say that A inverse raised to the fifth power, that will also become identity. So once I know that A raised to 5 is identity, I can say two things. I can say A inverse raised to 5 is also equal to identity. Okay. A raised to 5 is identity, then A raised inverse raised to 5 is also equal to identity. So this means that the above equation, this equation star, what will that equation star become? That equation star will become, I will write that equation again, A raised to 5 into B into A raised to minus A inverse raised to 5 is how much? B raised to 32. And now we know that this is coming to be identity. This is given to us. And order of A inverse is also 5. So this is in identity and we are getting B alone. And this is B raised to 32. So this means that B is equal to what? B is equal to B raised to 32. So when I use B star identity is equal to B star B raised to 31, when I can do the left cancellation law, I will get what? I will get identity is equal to B raised to 31. And I know that B is not equal to identity, because it is given us in it is given to us in the question itself that B is not identity and B raised to 31 is equal to identity. But we again know that 31 is what? 31 is a prime number. So from this we can declare that order of B must be how much? Order of B must be equal to 31.